My question is about a power imbalance between my right and left legs. How much of an imbalance is significant? For a significant imbalance, what are the best ways to correct it? So he says, the answer may have come to me already when, at the end of a recent ride, a voice came to me sounding a lot like Chad saying, the single leg exercise, dummy. But no, I don't think that David, it's probably not the safest thing to be doing single leg drills when you're not on the trainer as well. So don't worry about that. But he says, I'm new to training and have been using a smart trainer, Taxneo T2, and a power meter. And he mentions that they're the Favero Asioma Duos, which are a pretty cool, accessible power or set of power meter pedals, which is cool. And he said he's only been doing that for a few months. According to the data they send to my Garmin app, the left leg usually generates 54 to 55% of the power and the right 45 to 46%. This is both indoors and outdoors. So he says that 8 to 10 watt difference seems significant to me. So I'm not going to share any names here, David, but before we go any further, I know of an Olympian that has a much more substantial leg imbalance than you do. And that athlete has tried to correct it. Whenever they try to correct it, they get injured and they get slower. And when they don't worry about it, they're fine. So it's just kind of the way that they're built. So first of all, we should probably reduce the stigma around that people feel they need to be 50-50 all the time. That does not need to happen. Your body isn't symmetrical. Doesn't matter.
That's actually one of the reasons too, why we don't show it, because it's a metric that we don't want you to try to optimize 50-50. It's not a goal. It's more like, hey, that's interesting. It's like your hair color. I talked to somebody, one of the top people at one of the power meter companies, and they were saying that they thought they had some, I don't know if they had data or was a hypothesis. I think there was data on it, but people that aren't symmetrical, they actually do better at the end of a race for hard efforts. It's like the other leg ends up compensating at the really hard stuff at the end of the race. And it's like having something in reserve. So they're going and their body's like has this, and then they can do some like hard attack. And it was actually seen as maybe a benefit for some people if you naturally do this. The thing is though, you can't like just try to be 50-50 all the whole time. So don't worry about that. The one thing is, if you do have what can happen for some people is based on the percentage of 50-50 or what it is will change at different wattages or how tired you are inside of a race. For workouts, it's not usually a huge difference and not enough to like impact your training, but a left right will be, if you really care about the details, you'll have a better understanding of your entire fitness versus just a left sided power meter. But again, it's not enough where you're like, well, I can't train with left sided power meter. I have access to lots of power meters in some bikes. I just have a left sided power meter, and y'all know me, I'm cool with it. So if I'm cool with it, you're probably cool with it too.
Yeah. Great explanation. He mentions that during one of his active recovery weeks since joining Trainer Road, he reached a 50-50 power output, achievement unlocked. He says, which tells me that the disparity occurs when I am pedaling hard. This is actually like a great misnomer right here, is that it doesn't just happen when you're pedaling hard. It happens. It's probably changes across a whole spectrum of intensity. Also based on the mobility that you've been doing prior to that, thereafter, strength training, you know, once again, it shouldn't be 50-50. You don't have to worry about that. He says the data
be too. It doesn't matter.
Yes, exactly. If it is, it is. If it's not, it's not. But that doesn't mean that you're a better or worse athlete as a result of it. He also then goes into talking about how like he was looking at where exactly it phased in and out of power and where he had a dead spot. And you can get really analytical with all this stuff. And this is a great example of focusing on what matters most and what moves the needle in terms of your performance. He says, I speculate the power difference occurs with his legs. He says, due to having better cycling dynamics with one leg over another. He also mentions that his left leg is the one that's the stronger one, but that's the one that he cramps with his left adductor when he rides. So this is a great example, Dave, of you digging into the details and getting a lot of insights. But those insights may not necessarily drive performance. That said, so I never look at my left-right balance. When I have seen it, just because I'm looking at other things usually, when I have seen it, it will fluctuate anywhere between like plus or minus 4% on either side. And whatever it is, and it might be more, it might be less, and changes throughout a ride. But the one thing that I would say is if you've had like some sort of like a traumatic leg injury, like you've broken your leg and you're coming back from something and you're really easing your way into training, I could see this being helpful, right? Because you don't probably want to be 50-50 when you start out with a leg that really needs to be worked on. But at the same time, I've made this mistake. Don't make this mistake. Don't think that because you have a leg imbalance that and quantified by your left-right balance, that it's like my legs are messed up and I need to do PT and I need to change everything about what I'm doing. They don't correlate like that. So that's just make sure that you don't do that. That could be bad.
This is what, in order for us to like put this in the product and try to drive people to improve this, I'd want to see something where either anecdotal or a study where, maybe, let's say you took, there's pro riders and they said, if they do that, the best pro riders in the world are 50-50. And then the less you are balanced, the worse rider you are. That would be some data. Or we'd say, okay, the study that took people, they were 50-50 with no training interventions. They just got, or they weren't 50-50. Making them 50-50 then increase their wattage or the performance by a significant amount. Those kind of things would be like, hey, then they should be 50-50. As far as I know, there's none of that. There might be anecdotal that someone say, but I worked on this and at the same time this happened. That's the N equals one, which we do a lot on the podcast anyways, but not enough to then change the whole product. But if you said, if, for instance, if, I don't know, Chris Froome, he just goes, oh, I've been 46, you know, 52 or 50, whatever the math is, this whole time. That's why I've been losing the tour. He changed it and then he just smoked everybody. That would still be an N equals one, but that would maybe be a little more, that wouldn't be enough either. You need a lot of data and a lot of people in order to do this, but it seems right. It seems like you go, hey, I have to be symmetrical. I need to work on this. Not the case.
Can we focus? Go ahead,
Ivy. Oh yeah. The only thing that I would add, I mean, it's, I do agree that like we shouldn't, you know, hyper-focus on being 50-50, but if there's pain associated with like what you perceive to be your weak side, or you have like lower back pain or a neck pain or some sort of imbalance that you think could be causing that, like apart from performance, like seek medical advice, you know, like you could have like a strain or an imbalance or something off center that's causing that imbalance that you should be looking at and getting, you know, seeking advice and help on apart from just a performance standpoint.
Yeah. Chances are your left, right power balance data is not going to be the thing that's really going to be showing that. And you getting the PT isn't going to fix that. What Ivy said is if you're experiencing pain and discomfort, then you should, right? Not if you see a 54, 46 split. Math is hard. Yeah. Sorry.
That's it.
One other thing that I just want to mention on this, that left adductor during rides. I don't know about anybody else. That's usually the first thing to cramp for me when I'm in a race is my adductors, like the, yeah. Right. And it's a painful one because it's really long. So like you get like the cramp for a whole long ways up your leg. That I've noticed a reduction in my left adductor, or sorry, not left adductor, just adductor strains and cramps, that sort of stuff, direct correlation to strength training. And the strength training that I do usually has me doing, it's more like, you know, I'll be squatting with like a kettlebell, but you could do the squatting without any weight as well. And you'll absolutely get the benefit, but it's like lateral side squats. It's going to be squats that are going to be like split leg squats, different things like that, that are working my legs in different planes of motion. And when I'm doing that and I'm staying up on my strength training, I get zero strains, cramps, anything else like that. And this is probably in this case, David, I know that you're looking at this data, wondering if you have an imbalance, but you should just do strength training if you don't already. Especially if you can find like a strength training coach that really helps you with cycling in particular, that would be awesome. And if you do that, you'll notice a huge improvement across how you feel on the bike.
If you like this video, make sure you give us a thumbs up.
If you didn't like this video, you can give it a thumbs down, but let us know what you would have done differently in the comments below.
If you want to see more of these videos, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you want to become a faster cyclist, check out trainerroad.com.
Do it.